Nicola, and we're here today to speak to Amanda Shell from Puriskin. Now, the reason we're speaking to Amanda today is simply because they've gone into collaboration with Birchbox. Now, as some of you may know, Birchbox is an amazing beauty box subscription system that allows people to try out new and emerging brands. And Puriskin is one of those amazing new and emerging brands. Now, it's been in the month of May, Beauty Box, and because of the raving success that Puriskin have received, we have decided to get Amanda to take a few seconds or a few minutes out of her busy day to answer some of the many over 600 questions, reviews, comments that we've had, so that you guys, those of you that have never heard of Puriskin before, and those of you that have but want to learn a little bit more, can hear from one of the people that really represents the brand, understands the brand, and communicates to you guys exactly what it does and what it's all about. So thank you, Amanda, for taking so much time out of your day. I know the people that use Puriskin and will be using Puriskin will really appreciate this. But can you explain a little bit about yourself, a little bit about your background and who you are?
Hi, thanks for so much for making the time for me as well today. And I'm delighted to be here. I'm primarily an acupuncturist by training and herbalist, and I also lecture on skin rejuvenation as well. Puriskin, I discovered this product about 3 years ago, and I have been recommending it to people I treat for home use. I've been using it in my clinic, and I have just fallen in love with the results that we get. It's a really gentle, wonderful product. But more importantly, it does what I need it to do, and that's helped skin to heal.
Wonderful, wonderful. I think that is a really nice introduction. Now, as I said before, we've had over 600 comments and reviews. So, Amanda, are you ready for some of the questions that people have asked about Puriskin?
Of course, I am.
So, of the 600, we've taken like a sample of across of the most popular questions. So, question number one. A few people have mentioned that they do not understand how it is resurfacing. What does resurfacing actually mean?
There's quite a few definitions about resurfacing. I think the most kind of popular and widely known is the idea of a scrub. And in a more dramatic sense, it's these treatments that people receive where they're having dermal abrasion resurfacing through a physical means. Now, what we don't want to do is actually damage the skin. And the beauty of what Puriskin does, it has natural components within it, which create a sort of keratinitic cleansing effect. In particular, it's the allantoin, which is from the root of the comfrey plant, which heals tissue, actually helps bind it together. It was always known as nip bone in the First World War. It was used to heal tissue. But when you have issues with skin, and this protective moisture barrier, known, I think everyone knows it as the epidermis, the top layer, the bit where all the dead skin is, that's the bit that can compromise skin health. To try and help people understand, if you look at the skin under an electron microscope, I'm going to show you a picture. This is what it looks like. It looks like roof tiles. And I have a great picture of broken roof tiles, but I'm sure everyone can imagine that if your roof had broken roof tiles, it would start to leak. And that's kind of how the skin works. So when we say a resurfacing formula, what we don't want to do is mechanically damage the roof tiles, okay? Because if we do that, we compromise its protective effect for our body. It's a moisture barrier. Without it, it's going to cause inflammation, which is another thing that Puriskin does. It reduces inflammation, things like comfrey, the chamomile, the cucumber in the different formulas, and we'll talk about that as well, help reduce inflammation and allow the skin to heal. So another issue with resurfacing, as that's what we're discussing, is that when the skin is rough, you get a lot of shadow, okay? A bit like at the moon, the surface of the moon. And so although your complexion might be reasonably healthy, if you have bumps and lumps, that doesn't look very pretty. So a lot of people say, for example, with open pores, wrinkles as well, but open pores in particular, or acne scarring, look to go to these resurfacing procedures to try and smooth that surface over. And a lot of quite dramatic and require quite a long healing time. If you think about it, we're natural things, we're living things. So it's better we have a slow, gentle process rather than wham bang, heavy duty assault to fairly precious environmental protective agent, which I showed you is the surface of the skin. So if you damage the skin, you're going to allow inflammatory products in there, such as SLS, which occurs in a lot of cleansers, which are irritants, basically. So you've got a roof leaking, you're letting in irritant products, which are going to, in the long term or even the short term, cause further problems. I've got another picture as well. It's not a very good one, but it'll give you an idea. This is a picture, two sides. One, this is a scientifically produced image. The top one shows normal absorption of active ingredients within the skin. Okay, it's a barrier. It's supposed to be like that. It's not supposed to let anything in. After resurfacing, microneedling, and to be honest, damaged skin as well, you get a much higher intake. I mean, the red represents the amount of active ingredient that's going to be absorbed, which is fabulous if it's good ingredient, but if it's irritant, you can imagine the damage and irritation, further irritation you might cause. So in short, resurfacing is about smoothing the surface. We seem to be able to achieve that through the effects of using Pure Skin as a cream, which is anti-inflammatory, helps the skin regulate these lovely tiles, which we showed you before, are able to regenerate slowly and in order and resume their function. And in the short term, what Pure Skin does, it leaves a fine film protecting the skin in order for that process to happen. It doesn't irritate. And as I will discuss as well, you can wash with it, use it as a primer. But basically, it's there to protect the cells and enable them to recover. Does that help?
That is so amazing. That is very in-depth. And I'm sure that people will get to understand it better through that answer. So thank you very much. Okay, so very next, very popular question was, what's the difference between the cream, Pure Skin cream, and Pure Skin formula?
Okay, both products are very, very soothing on the skin, and they both have a very, very similar effect. The big difference is that the pink formula, that's the formula, has been designed with actually through feedback from a lot of medical professionals and people who have been having quite harsh treatments such as radiotherapy, chemotherapy, which would damage them for an internal reason, radiotherapy obviously for external reasons. So their skin is compromised, it's tender, it's sore, radiotherapy's burnt skin. So if you have very sensitive skin, although none of the scents in the products are artificial in any way, chamomile tea is a natural scent, okay? And it is that that creates the healing effect as well. We use cucumber in the formula, which is even more cooling and has no scent at all. Sometimes it's almost a psychological thing that you don't want to be smelly.
Can you repeat that bit again, please, Amanda? You broke up.
Yes, of course. So the chamomile tea in the cream, I particularly love, because when I'm doing beauty treatments and when people just want to use it on a daily basis, I just have to adore that natural smell. It's a natural scent, cold pressed essential oils in the products, so nothing artificial at all. But for some reason, people who have very, very compromised skin or had undergone a procedure of some kind are not only, they're not going to be actually sensitized to the cream, but they seem to want to have a smell-free product. The cucumber that we've put in the formula is particularly cooling and particularly soothing and particularly anti-inflammatory. It just has a particularly powerful effect in that direction, yet it's very, very gentle. So by not having a perfume, albeit not a, it's not a smell that's manufactured, but by having a natural scent of any kind, it is particularly safe to use on highly compromised broken root tiles.
Okay, so the difference between the cream and the formula is that formula is basically more sensitive, I guess, for particularly highly damaged skin. Is that correct?
It is, and by choice, because people prefer not to have any perfumed anything in a cream that has a more, if you like, dermatological function. It's, I mean, neither are medical products, but they seem to be having, and they can all be used at home. It's not a problem, but very safe, both very healing and calming. But it's just that the formula is particularly gentle on skin.
Perfect. Okay. Another question we've had is a few people have called the product a wonder product or wonder cream formula. Can one cream do so much?
I too always raise my eyebrows when I'm presented with the wonder product because, is it too good to be true? But it does do what it says on the tin. Most of the conditions that are listed on the box, scarring and all these things, have arisen from an inflammatory cause. Okay, so the ingredients that are in there are designed and have a history of traditional history of being very anti-inflammatory. And as I've said already, in order for skin to regulate itself and heal, you need to try and reduce that inflammation as much as you can. So, because most problems are, I mean, if I think about psoriasis, eczema, dermatitis, and itis is inflammation. So all the itises that the doctors like to speak about, that is basically an inflamed something. Okay, so dermatitis is an inflammation of the dermatological, the skin. Okay, so all the scarring is caused by heightened and also a risk from highly resurfacing procedures. It can cause scarring because the skin rushes to try and heal itself and produces a lot of scar tissue. And if the foundations aren't healthy, it cannot mature into normal regulated collagen, that lovely neat matrix, and becomes a scar. And again, that's caused by an inflammatory process. So the answer is yes, it is able to do pretty well. All the things that I've been using it for are to do with inflammation and all, and so yes, it is quite amazing actually. And I even get people saying to me, Amanda, I can't believe my face is looking so much smoother and my redness. I mean, I've even been treating keloids with it. Keloid scars are horrendous things that people get from surgery or even mosquito bites. They have obviously highly inflammatory environment inside. They seem to grow blood supplies and nerve supplies. These scars irritate, they itch, people scratch them, and they become, it's called a hyper meaning excessive trophic bump or lump on the skin, and it unfortunately grows, and if you operate on it continues to grow. So it's a real problem. But within a week, PuraSkin is reducing the irritation and stop, they don't scratch it anymore, and the redness is gone. And it can even shrink them. I'm not saying we're going to get rid of them, but it provides the relief. And I have some pictures of some horrendous keloids that people have actually presented to me. Can you help me, Amanda? And I've said, just use this cream. And they've come back in a week. And I said, go and see a dermatologist, make sure you're under medical intervention. But, they've said to me, it's better than the steroids. They're given steroid creams to do that same anti-inflammatory effect. But in a natural way, it seems to be soothing, calming, and if anything, preventing them from getting bigger. And that's the key. They may be there, they may shrink a bit. What we don't want them is to grow out of control. That's one example of what I've seen. And that was actually with cream, but now we have the formula, which was more recently produced. Clearly, I'd give them that because I want it to be very, very soothing indeed.
Yeah, to stop the itching and the scratching and the irritation.
Absolutely.
Okay,
Absolutely.
I understand now. Thank you. Another
That's
question,
okay.
through Birchbox is because we gave the samples in 15 mL tins, and a lot, many, I would say over 2/3 of the reviews were talking about how cute these little tins are. Do you sell them in the tins?
No, we don't. They were for branded sampling, and obviously they're a lovely way to do it. But the reality is, you're better off to have it in a tube or in an air pump. There's two ways you can deliver the product. At the moment, we're using the tubes. Two reasons. One is we don't want to contaminate the product. I always say to people coming to me, Clickly, for God's sake, if you're not going to use some of the products I'm recommending, if you're going to use products, use obviously free from products, but new products, because unfortunately these things grow bacteria. So if you've got compromised tissue, you do not want to allow bacteria to go in and cause an infection, okay? So it's better for these products to be kept in a more closed environment, so you're only literally dispensing as you need it. That's kind of the primary reason. But what I say to people is, look, if you're going on holiday, and actually 50 mils you can travel without anyway, it's not a problem. But if you're going away for a weekend and you're going light, you can always buy a brand new little tin of your own, because obviously a tin's slightly more sterile anyway, and just decant a bit for your own personal use. But I wouldn't recommend a tins anyway. I think tinned things, particularly when you're looking at a product to clear inflammation, or you know, where you might have sensitivity, you're better off to have it as we are giving it in a tube or an airless pump.
Okay. All right, great. Yeah. People have mentioned that they did not see results within a few days. How long before you see results? You kind of like touched on that with the keloids, but how long before people can start seeing results on maybe a scar or sunburn or something like that?
It's a good question. It's one that challenges me every day. Because what we do, you can't fix something overnight. I actually use the analogy of a plant. If you love your plant and you put a seed in some soil and you nurture the soil and you give it the right light and a bit of water and food, it's going to start growing. And generally, it's going to take about 3 months to use a tomato plant or whatever
you want. Can you repeat that, please? How many long 3 months did you say?
3 months, 10 to 12 weeks before you can actually see something. So I'm not saying it's going to work in 10 to 12 weeks either, because we get people reporting results in a week. Mm-hmm. It depends on their health, the condition being treated, and it's not an instant fix. Unfortunately, if you want the magic of an instant fix, that's where your steroids come in. They have long-term results, issues, such as thinning the skin, and they're not something one would want to use chronically, whereas something like PuraSkin could be used chronically. I say it means over a long period of time without there being any side effect issues. So if you want a quick fix, you might pay the price for the side effect. Remember, the whole point of a product like this is to regulate the function, the pH of the skin, and let the body heal naturally and slowly. As I said already, fast healing could result in scarring, okay? And even people who take Rioccutane for acne, I get people coming in with acne, had Rioccutane to heal the acne quickly. Suddenly, that's when they started getting scars. They're slow is better, and it sometimes will take a little longer.
Okay. All right. So it just depends on the whole holistic, your whole body, as well as...
It really does. And that's where treatments like acupuncture come in, because it's not just treating the local area. You're looking at actually improving the machine, making it function. That's kind of what acupuncture does. It's like reprogramming a computer to make sure everything works more harmlessly together, harmoniously. And that's kind of what we're trying to achieve.
Okay, brilliant. We've only got a couple more questions.
Okay.
So next question is this cream supposed to be used as a moisturizer? Because some people have used it on direct issues, and then some people speak about it as using it as a cream to sleep, go to bed at night, and wake up. So is it supposed to be used as a moisturizer?
Absolutely. It's a fantastic moisturizer. And where I've had people coming to me with particularly oily, acne skin, active acne, what we want to do is regulate the sebum of the skin, because the skin feels dry. People strip it with really harsh cleansers such as an SLS product. Most foaming shampoos, body products, soaps are foamy because of this sodium lauryl sulfate. It's a compound actually sent to grease, used to degrease engines, unfortunately. So they're using a product like that. The skin says, oh, I'm very dry, I'd better produce more sebum, more oil, to moisturise myself. So what we want to do is gently cleanse the skin, and we can use PuraSkin to cleanse. You wet a pad and just massage into the face and rinse. It can then be used as a moisturizer afterwards, and even it primes you for makeup because it creates a lovely smoothing effect on the skin. It's perfect as a base for moisturizer, but absolutely, it can be. That's what I mean. It's standalone. You can use it to wash, moisturize, and prime all in one.
Okay, good.
If I'm being particularly dry, I will actually moisturize it, rub some in my hand, and just pat it on my face, just to hydrate any areas. But whether the skin's oily or dry, it seems to regulate that.
Okay, brilliant. And the final question, I think you kind of answered it already. The cream has a smell and the formula does not. And I mean, had to ask them.
I love the chamomile tea smell. And actually what I sometimes do, I put a little drop of my lavender oil in and the two together smell divine. Mm. But it's very much a personal choice. Mm. And that's the only thing I would say is if you know you are very, very, very sensitive. And one way of telling that is if you scratch your skin and it goes red really quickly. I see with patients, I'll press their skin and it's red straight away. It doesn't have any information. Then I'd possibly go towards something that's really gentle. If you're hardcore and you can use any creams, then I would definitely use the cream. But the smell is just, it's a personal choice, actually.
Yeah.
First thing, it's safe to use on young children and pregnant women because it's so pure. It's vegetarian friendly, contains no animal testing at all, and it's all botanicals. Okay, it contains only botanical ingredients. My favourite thing is the absorption of the product, even on hands. It does not leave a greasy residue at all. You get that with petrochemicals, and when you've got parabens and things, all these emulsifiers in the products, particularly petrochemicals, they leave a greasy coating. And I hate that if I'm going to do acupuncture on someone, to have that on my skin when I'm trying to work with their faces. So it's really important the product just goes straight in very, very quickly. It absorbs quickly and does what it, and protects your skin with that moisture protecting barrier. And because it absorbs and it doesn't contain petrochemicals and parabens, it feels very light on the skin. You don't even notice it's even there. So that's kind of really what I love. But being plant-based, being a vegetarian-friendly product, I think is really, really important. And I guess finally, my completely brilliantly, amazingly favourite tiger grass. Tigers actually roll in this. That's why it's called tiger grass, when they hurt themselves. And what it does, it protects the skin. It helps heal the skin by improving collagen and elastin production. And that's why they lie in it. And it added to all the other wonderful botanicals in there. That's kind of my favorite thing about the product, because it's not something you find in products every day. I think that's the magic, actually.
So the top five again are, it's good for young people and pregnant women.
Absolutely. It's botanical.
It's botanical.
Free.
Yeah.
So it absolutely doesn't contain any steroids, petrochemicals or parabens. And particularly petrochemicals leave a greasy kind of coating all over the skin, which I hate. I mean, it gets on your glasses. You know, if you try and put hand cream on with the skin, it leaves, you can't dry, it's just slipping all over the place. It's highly absorbent, goes straight into the skin, and it's quickly in because of all the botanicals in there.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much, Amanda.
That's a pleasure. It's a pleasure.
So what we're going to do is, obviously, we're going to ensure that people can see this and ask more questions on every single platform. So if you don't mind, we might get you back in. So if people want to ask questions, we'll put links below as well in all our platforms to share, and yes, they can get in touch with you through AccuRegion, which is as well as log on to Birchbox and be able to purchase the products there. So thank you so much, Amanda.
Oh, pleasure.
Thank you.